Break out the IT bingo card. We've got another acronym for you. Let's talk SIEM. Welcome back to Brain Bytes. I'm Blake Boyd, and joining me as always is James Green. James, how are we doing today?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm not doing too bad. Today, we are going to add another acronym to your lexicon of IT alphabet soup acronym.
Oh my goodness. We should totally make one that people can print out and check off.
We absolutely should. An IT bingo card. We
really should. Totally an IT bingo card.
So today we're talking about SIEM. S-I-E-M. SIEM, yes. with a silent E. So SIEM is Security Information and Event Monitoring. So this is, I guess it's a relatively new tool.
I'd agree with that. Yep.
I guess it's a tool. It's not really a concept. It's kind of an amalgamation of two things that already existed: security information monitoring and security event monitoring.
Yep.
So at a high level, you can consider a SIEM sort of an aggregator of security, information and events. There are, and even on this podcast, we've talked about a number of different cybersecurity solutions from MDR, antivirus, multi-factor authentication.
Yep.
So what SIEMs do is they kind of condense all of these different systems down into one place.
Right.
And what they can, from basic standpoint, they just kind of ingest all of the information that these different systems are outputting. So all the alerts all show up in one spot.
Yep.
But then you can also configure them to do essentially, workflows, you could call it, based on the information from these different systems. So say you get an alert for something in your MDR or your EDR platform. If that alert is for something that is like an internal process, you can have your SIEM trigger a workflow based on that, as opposed to treating it as like a huge event. Because, if you know that compiling this particular, code for application development or something always triggers this alert, you don't want to turn your EDR system down, because that is that's just bad across the board.
Right.
You want it to be alerting you as much as possible. You can filter out that noise a bit and say, okay, well, hey, we know that every time this particular process runs, it triggers an alert. So, hey, maybe you might want to ignore that.
Yep. And that's what's great about a SIEM is, and again, this is just another layer. This is another layer in your security stack. Just like with anything, there isn't a magic bullet. There isn't the one thing, deploy, we're good to go. This is that layer that, like Blake said, it brings all of that data together. It becomes that one-stop shop. But it is the automation and orchestration that it can do that makes it great.
Right, because all these tools, a lot of these tools that we've talked about and that a lot of companies are implementing, they help protect you from outside threats. They help protect you from either bad guys trying to get in, bad guys that have already gotten in, spreading, moving laterally across the network. But what a SIEM can help you do is a SIEM can help protect you from inside threats. So, let's say, for example, here at Becca, we have a SIEM and it is configured to watch our network traffic for LogMeIn, the remote access program LogMeIn. We do a lot of remote access to computers. So if we just looked for remote access as a whole, that'd be a problem.
Yep.
But we don't do any remote access via LogMeIn. We use different tools for that. So if we see someone using LogMeIn, then that might be someone in our office that has inadvertently allowed remote access to their computer. While LogMeIn is a perfectly valid solution, it is a perfectly valid software, but we don't use it for anything day-to-day in our office. So we've gone into our SIEM and said, hey, if you see LogMeIn, no, that's not good.
Right.
Let's alert to that. Let's run that up the flagpole. Make sure someone knows that they're using LogMeIn. And there have been, since we implemented that, there have been legitimate use cases for LogMeIn, kind of edge cases, right? We've had vendors who need to do support with our team on something. So, internal support for us, not for customers. And they happen to use LogMeIn.
Right.
So, the team knows that we're watching for LogMeIn. And so they'll post and say, hey guys, I have a legitimate use case for LogMeIn here. And now we know, right? And so when the SIEM throws the alert, as long as we can verify that it is that person who said they were using LogMeIn, we know. So it can help you protect yourself against perfectly legitimate software packages or perfectly legitimate things that are going on in your office that shouldn't be happening, right? Like, right. We also have Dropbox configured. So we are, you know, I think it's been very clear over the years, we are a Microsoft everything. So we use OneDrive and SharePoint. We don't use Dropbox, Box, Share, whatever, any of these other document management or document sharing systems. So if all of a sudden we see a ton of document or a ton of traffic being sent to or from Dropbox, that's a red flag because, okay, so it could be something benign, like, you know, I'm just downloading a, you know, a file share, some a client took a bunch of pictures and shared them with me through their Dropbox. Again, totally reasonable use case and something that you would just investigate and say, okay, no, that's supposed to happen. Or on the, you know, more malicious side of things that you hope you never have to deal with, someone could be exfiltrating data out of your business. You could have a, you know, a, an employee who's disgruntled for whatever reason, and they've decided that, you know, they're going to give their 2 weeks notice, but before they do, they're taking everything with them.
Yep.
They could download a Dropbox, create a Dropbox account, put Dropbox on the computer, and just start exfiltrating data into that Dropbox share. And without a SIEM, you would never know because your firewall is going to let Dropbox through.
Right.
Because it's Dropbox. It's a perfectly legitimate software.
Yeah, it's that alert, it's that automation that at least brings it to your attention more than just, you know, oh, why is there so much traffic going to Dropbox? What do we need to look at here?
Right.
So, and so the automation part is great. The other piece that I like about it, especially for our department, as we talked about a couple weeks ago when we talked about cybersecurity checklists, a lot of these SIEM tools have reporting built into them.
Correct.
So it can spit out quite easily rather than us going through a checklist and go like, do they have this? Okay, yeah, okay, they have that. Okay, do they have this? Okay, they have that. The SIEM tool just says, I need to run a report on PCI DSS compliance.
Yep.
Here you go. I need to run a report on GDPR. Here you go. It's that nice one-stop shop. It's using all of its AI and machine learning to bring in all this data, compile it, and then that way it can just spit you out that report.
Right, and this is actually, this episode kind of goes hand in hand with the episode we're going to release next week or the following about compliance and what it is, why you should care, and how you can, you know, manage it, and how you can make sure you're doing the things that these compliance regulations or controls have laid out there. And with a SIEM, a SIEM by itself is nothing. It's literally just a container. Yep. So you have to have all these other pieces to feed it information. But once you start feeding it information, it can become very powerful, and it can
so powerful.
It can understand it. Well, again, it can use machine learning, not, you know, it can use AI buzzword, right? To determine what's going on in your environment. It can establish baselines. It can say this is in baseline, this is out of line, you know, and it can help you get a really granular view of what's going on inside your environment and maybe where some weaknesses are from a security standpoint.
Yep. Yeah, it gives you that one-stop shop, that aggregation of all this data to help you make better choices.
Yeah, and another thing it can do that is actually has nothing to do with security products is it can ingest log files from either appliances, applications, in like operating systems like Windows. So you can actually ingest your Windows operating system log files into a SIEM, and you can start making correlations, right? So you can make a correlation between a Dropbox connection having a large amount of data being transferred to and from that connection. And then you can then pair that with the computer that has the IP address that the connection's coming from, and then pair that further with the Windows log files for that computer as to see what data exactly is transferring. So while Dropbox by itself, just inspecting that network traffic would never be able to tell you what file is moving, when you start bringing all of these different things together into a SIEM, you actually could potentially, again, obviously depending on configurations and all that stuff, but you could potentially see who and what files exactly are being moved to Dropbox just because you're able to very easily, quickly, and indexed, I think is the most important, searchable index to compare these two completely separate systems, right? Because normally your network traffic and file system logs from an operating system would never correlate together at all. They don't exist in the same, you know, they don't exist together. But when you put them together in a SIEM, and the SIEM can say, okay, well, I know this IP address is starting that connection, and I know that IP address belongs to this computer. Now they've found a common connection, and it can compile those results together.
Yep.
Well, we hope you learned a little bit about what a SIEM is and how to spell it, S-E-I-M, S-I-E-M. See, look, I didn't even know. So thank you very much for listening, and we will see you next week.
See ya.